In this video, we will discuss saved plan views and how to control them from the layout file associated with the plan. The saved plan view is a tool that provides a one-click button that will set your floor level, your layer set, your annotation set, and the reference display settings all at once. Once you have the saved plan view active, you can send this view to layout with all those settings active. Now, this layout box is linked to the saved plan view. If you go back to your plan file and make any changes to the saved plan view, it will update automatically in your layout. After sending the plan view to layout, you have options for controlling the saved plan view from here without having to go back and forth to your plan file. If I click on this layout box, the related edit menu will show up here at the bottom of the page. These are all of the tools that allow you to edit the object selected. By clicking on the Unlinked Save Plan View button in the edit menu, you can disassociate or unlink the saved plan view that was active when the plan was sent. Now, if for instance I were to go back to the plan file and change the layer set associated with the saved plan view, and then click on the Save Plan View button, it will not reflect the change in the layout. They are unlinked. I'll go back and undo that change. Also, if you have unlinked the Save Plan View from this layout box, you can use the Open Object tool in the Edit toolbar to open the Layout Box Specification dialog. Here I can change what is displayed in the layout box. You can change the floor level that is displayed and change the annotation set that is displayed. You can also change the reference display settings to show a reference floor level and control which floor is referenced. You can also change the displayed layer set. Close the Layout Box Specification dialog, and then, with the layout box still selected, click on the Layout Box Layers button. That will open the Layer Display Options dialog. Here you can change the layer set that is being used and/or edit the layers displayed in that layer set. Now that I have made those changes to what is displayed in the layout box, if I want to save these settings as a new saved plan view, I can close this dialog. Then here in the Edit toolbar, note that the Unlinked Saved Plan View button has converted to a new tool, the Create Saved Plan View button. I'll save this as the basement electrical plan. Now, if I go back to the plan file, you can see the new basement electrical plan here in the saved plan view. If you want to relink the layout box to the original saved plan view, you can select the layout box, use the Open Object tool to again open the layout box specification dialog, and as you can see here, the linked saved plan view says Basement Electrical Plan. To relink the original saved plan view or link to a different saved plan view, you can click on the drop-down menu and select one that is already saved in the plan file. If I select the second floor plan and click OK, you can see that it is now showing the second floor level with the correct layer set and annotation set. I'll change it back to the original saved plan view, the first floor plan. In the Layout Box Specification dialog, you also have the option to display the dimensions number height larger or smaller than the dimensions default text height. Note when I go back to the floor plan in the plan file, the default number height here has not changed. It only changed how it's displayed in the layout. You can change it back to display the default number height by clicking on the little white wrench to reset the default text height. Saved plan views are a great time-saving production tool when used in coordination with the layout file. Creating, editing, and saving saved plan views directly from your layout will add even more to your production time when creating construction drawings.